Your holy name. children have all his possessions, and parents to be made. So the slave fell on his knees before him, saying, have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the lord of that slave released him and forgave him the debt. But that sinning slave, as he went up, came upon one of the fellow slaves who owed him 100 denarii, and seized him by the throat and said, pay what you owe. And the fellow slave fell down and pleaded with him, have patience with me, and I will pay. But he refused. And he went and threw him into prison until he would pay the debt. When his fellow slaves saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed. And they went and reported to their lord all that had taken place. Then his lord sat on him and said to him, you wicked slave, I forgave you all that debt because you pleaded with me. Should you not have had mercy on your fellow slave, as I had mercy on you? And in anger his lord ordered him, handed him over to be tormented, to be tortured, until he would pay with his entire debt. So, my heavenly Father will also do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother or sister from your heart. This is the Gospel of Christ.
The revolution of slavery has been slavery is okay. But Jesus is not saying that. He's simply drawing on the pattern of behavior that exists. And so in the Matthew church, the church of Matthew, there's a notion of forgiveness, repentance, and reconciliation. Reconciliation is important for human history throughout our existence. Forgiveness, repentance, and reconciliation. And these must be the hallmarks of the watchword for us, for justice of sin. That's very interesting, maybe, of confirmation class. So we are making an examination of the topic. So we look at Amos. And Michael. And we were examining in class some of the things that they said. And so yesterday morning, one of the things that we examined is one of the things we noted about the topics is that many times in which terms like justice and righteousness would come forth from the lips of the topic. Justice, righteousness, reconciliation. These are extremely important words for us. So in the details of the parable, these are the kinds of things that will come out along with honor and privilege. The context for the parable is Peter's question. Peter's question is one that perhaps comes up in our own minds every now and again. How often someone do something wrong? How often should someone be particularly offensive? How often should my brother or sister sin against me? How many chances should he get from me? That's a very simple question. And I'm not for sure if I'm going to think about this question. Sometimes, you know, the issues that come to us keep recurring. And sometimes we are offended by the same people. That's the nature that little bother is repeated. So we are asked, how often should someone sin against me and I do it? How often should I do it? Sometimes, maybe 15, maybe. At least 20 times, because common sense is, that I can't keep forgiving someone over and over again for the same offense. Should it go seven times? And so Jesus is saying seven times, he's not giving, you have to be very careful when you do this, Jesus is not giving a limit. Jesus is not putting a limit on forgiveness. He's not putting a limit. But he's saying, here, in this gospel, you say you must always be forgiven. You must always be forgiven. Perhaps you could ask for a show of hands. After those who will always be forgiven. Amen. Jesus says you must always be forgiven. You must always forgive. You must always forgive. And then in the this is your Heavenly Father. You very say the Lord's Prayer, for example. We ask God to forgive us and be forgive others. And this is not a very interesting theme running through Scripture. Now, the interesting theme running through Scripture, the whole notion of that is called cause and effect. If you do X, Y will follow. If you do X, Y will follow. And this we find that throughout the pages of one thing will lead to another. This scripture says, sin will go forward, if you let me say wrong. If you do it wrong, you'll get wrong. Let me think about wine. Strong drink. This will be result. If you show mercy, mercy will be shown to you. If you forgive, you will be forgiven. That seems to run that understanding of life. It can run through the pages of Satan's book. So it was all the people. So in the details, there is the notion of one who was a slave and who owed debt, who was forgiven the debt, but then refused to be forgiven. But then refused to be forgiven. So the interpretation here of the power is that just as the king, as it were, in this passage, the spirit to forgive him, so God is also here to forgive us. And since God Almighty has forgiven us our trespasses, so we also must be willing, must be prepared to forgive others. So we are told that in the details of the parable, that in anger the Lord had him over to the torture of his entire death. So the passage, as it were, brings out the practical element of what it means to be a Christian. Now, fear, concern. Must all this be the terms that are uppermost in our minds? That God Almighty desires of us, the church community, that we are the forgiven and the forgiving community. And that we must lead others along those kinds of lines as well. Those within our care and within our charge. Those help persons to understand that kindness will follow kindness. In the Far East, the Buddhist religion, but as an interesting saying, that the child of unkind parents will become unkind. What it says is that we must engender love and care, concern, kindness, and then this will be replicated across our community. In the world in which we live, this is the message that we must take into the world and across nations. For we find that forgiveness and repentance and reconciliation often seem to be lost among us. Both in the local common conversation and in the international world as well, that it always seems to go about our one community, that I must then say that I have more power, I have largesse, I have all these things at my disposal, that is strong, all this need to want to put down the weak, which goes against the notion of what Christianity is all about. So repentance, forgiveness, and reconciliation are critical. If the human family is to come together, if we are truly to bring the battle against sin and evil and disease. But indeed, there's a challenge to forgiveness and reconciliation. The challenges can continue for a long time. So there is speak of these challenges. The world in which we live is still a toxic state because some human beings feel that they have dominion or domination over another. So our message must be connected as we proclaim God's message of reconciliation and repentance and forgiveness. The world in which we live now, as we said, is still in a toxic state because of the issues and the challenges that has come about as a result of this spirit on this spirit on human history. here to make that patient see that he has made bad decisions in the company or other. Then we will be reconciled one to another as we face the challenges that come from us. May God bless thank you with us, and may this word all be over as we seek to carry out God's mission here. May God Almighty be with us. May He give us His strength. May He enable us to be His ministry, so that we may allow the light and brightness of reconciliation to shine forth from the name of the walls of the church out into the wide world. So my heavenly Father, the God who is ahead of you, if you do not forgive your brother, as we say the next thing we get, believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty.
Thank you.
feet of the Lord, we all be with you.
Thank you. Thank you. The hymn 589.
eternal God and heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us to the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant us strength and courage to love and serve you. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your heart and mind in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Just want to extend very warm greetings to one and all of the attending Mass today and those joining us online. Just a reminder that the midweek Mass begins this week, midweek Mass on Wednesday evening at 7. So that will be resuming this week. Also, the special service block will resume on Friday, the 25th of September at 5:30. Pray that God Almighty will continue to bless us and keep us safe.
Session on hymn 314.
Serve the Lord.